So a big new feature of iOS 12 is screen time. This allows you to track where you spend your time on your iPhone or iPad, and it also allows you to add restrictions. So let's take a look at it. You find it in the Settings app. In the Settings app you've got screen time. So you go in here and the first thing you're going to see is an update at the top showing you how you're using your time. It's going to break things down basically by app category. So you can see here, this is the beginning of a day. I've only spent a few minutes on my iPhone and I've used some creativity apps, reading and reference, and some other apps here. Now I can see more details just by tapping there, and you can see a graph. You can also switch between today and the last 7 days where I get much more detailed information since there's not much going on yet today. And I can see not only the categories there underneath that little chart, but also I can see my most used apps. So I can switch between categories and apps. And I can tap on an app to see more about it, like what category it's in and things like that. So I can really get a good idea of my use. Further down on that screen I can see things like pickups and the number of times I picked up my phone. And this graph may grow in usefulness over time as I see, like, more or less, you know, during the day how many times I pick things up. Also the number of notifications I'm getting and where those notifications are coming from. And I can tap on an app here and instantly change the notification settings. I don't have to leave screen time, go into the notification settings and change that. So if I see there's an app here that's notifying me a lot and I feel, well, I don't really need notifications from that app, I can change it right here without leaving the screen time section. So if I go back here, you can see that there's all these other things I can set. So I can set downtime. So downtime allows me to set a period of time where I can't access apps. Now I'll show you in a second how to change, you know, which apps can bypass this. But I could set, you know, some time where I really can't access anything except those apps that I've set to bypass it. I could also go to app limits and add a limit here. So I can select a category here. So I can say, okay, let's do games, add, and set a limit saying only 2 hours a day. And I can go in here and edit and change which apps. And I can group a few together. So I can group a few different types of them. And I can add a bunch of these. So I can add a limit on games, a limit on creativity, all that sort of thing. And it's easy enough to go in and delete that limit as well. Now here under Always Allowed, this is where I set which apps ignore this. So here, for instance, my phone is going to ignore that. The phone app will still allow people to call me and I can call them. And also messages, FaceTime, and Maps, they're all going to ignore that. But I can add other apps, ones that are critical, in here so that whatever limits I set, they're not going to go by those rules. Now you can also set limits if you go in and look at your graph there and look at the top apps. So I can go and say the news app and say I'm using that too much. I can actually add a limit for that specific app right there. So you can limit those apps that are just taking up too much of your time. You can also set restrictions. So on things like purchases and which apps are allowed at all, privacy settings, all these different things, you can set them up. It's basically, it's like parental restrictions, but it's now inside of screen time. And once you've set that all up, then it's kind of an honor system thing, right? Because you can get blocked out of something, but you could just go back in here and change that. So it's kind of, you have to use some self-control to actually use screen time. But you can set a code. And this code could then be used to, or if the device belongs to a minor, of course it restricts their access to actually make changes to screen time. Now you can also share across devices. So if you have, say, an iPhone and an iPad and you want to set up screen time and limit your time across both devices, you can turn this on for both devices and it will share it because you're using the same Apple ID. You can also turn off screen time altogether down there with a button at the bottom. That's just a convenient way to switch that stuff off. So screen time is something where you can just ignore it, or you can actually go through it and set it and maybe try to help it change your behavior, or try to restrict use of a device by a child in your household.